and there ain't nothing anyone can do about it. Yet, here's me saying, I believe there's a God. Yet, I can't even answer my own doubts. I just don't know what to believe anymore.
All these years a Christian, why are you doubting now?
What do you mean, why am I doubting? Can't you see what's going on out there? The world is in chaos. And I want to know, if there's a God, then where is he?
Thomas, don't lose heart by what you see happening around the world. God is still in control. Jesus said all these things would happen because man has strayed so far from him. You've got to learn to trust God.
No, it's different now, okay? Times have changed. Look, you're different. You are his disciples, you're John, you're Peter. These times are different now, okay?
No, Thomas, that's where you've got it all wrong. We are no different to you. People today need an experience with God the same way we once did.
It's been the same for every person in every generation. Remind yourself of those in the scriptures and the great faith they had.
Oh, I know the stories, okay?
Yes, but you have not understood them, Thomas.
You mean I haven't understood them?
Thomas, what I'm trying to say is that they had their own struggles in trusting in God, the same way you do, the same way I did. I'm Peter, remember? But God is faithful. He'll always see us through.
Do you remember Abraham?
Abraham.
And the great faith he had when God called him to sacrifice Isaac, his beloved son?
Look, guys, look, baby, this is just not for me.
You need to see.
Come, Thomas. Come and see.
So to see.
Waited so long for a son and an heir. Do you really believe that God has asked you to sacrifice your only son? Do you know, old man, how crazy that sounds?
I am Almighty God. I have made my covenant with you. You
is anything too hard for the Lord. Do not be afraid, Abraham. I will be your shield. How can this be God's will? How can you sacrifice your one and only son? I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you. When the lad asked you, where is the sacrificial lamb? What will you say?
Set up potential and what he can make of us. Do you remember David? He was a simple, humble shepherd boy, but God used him in a mighty way to slay the giant Goliath and to save God's people Israel.
You're right, you know. Yeah, remember the stories about David? Yeah, God did some awesome things in his life. Wait, what about the sick people? You know, come on, what about the sick people in this world? What about those that are suffering in this world today? What about those that are far from God? Doesn't God care about them?
Thomas, you ask if God cares. You must understand what great love and humility it took for God himself, for Jesus, to come to this earth to show us the way back to the Father.
God traveled the corridors of time for everyone, for you, Thomas. Why? Because of his unending love for every person. We need to go back to where it all began. Come, let us go back to the Jordan.
Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me.
had to shut me up. But I cried out to him all the more. And then he called for me. And he asked me, "What do you want from me?" I said, "Rabboni, that I might see." And that's when he said those words. The words that changed my life forever. "Go. Your faith has made you well." Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you?
No one knows.
Neither do I condemn. Go and sin no more.
Thank you.
signs unless God is with you.
Most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.
How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter his mother's womb a second time and be born?
Most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of the water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That that is born of the flesh is flesh, and that that is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again.
How can these things be?
Are you a teacher of Israel, and you do not know these things? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
What must I do,
Nicodemus? Believe in me. Trust me.
Well, now take your money and go. continue, soon everyone will believe in him. And the Romans will come and take both our place and our nation.
Caiaphas, this cannot happen.
He must die, and his teachings and miracles of his will come to nothing, and his followers will fade away. Remember, it is better for you that one man dies for the people than for a whole nation perish.
Surely I say to you, he who receives whoever I send receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. Most assuredly I say to you, one of you seated here shall betray me.
Lord, who is it?
It is he to whom I shall give a piece of bread once I lift it. Children, I shall be with you a little while longer. You will seek me, but as I said to the Jews, where I am going you cannot come. So now I say to you, a new commandment I give to you, to love one another as I have loved you. In doing so, all shall know that you are my disciples indeed.
But where are you going?
Where I am going, you cannot follow me now. But you will follow me afterwards.
Lord, I will lay down my life for you.
Simon, Simon, will you lay down your life for my sake? Most assuredly I say to you, the rooster shall not crow this day until you deny me three times.
Lord, I will never deny you.
Never hunger.
My soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Stay here and watch.
Spoken by his own authority, the crowds would have stoned us to death. because they believe that John the Baptist was a prophet. And Nicodemus, you tell me, what did he say to us that day when we asked about paying taxes? What did he say? We'll tell you. He said,
render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's.
Nicodemus, we cannot outsmart this kind of wisdom anymore. Let Jesus speak parables to us. And I remind you, Nicodemus, that also includes you.
Nicodemus, at every opportunity, this Jesus has challenged our authority. Healing on the Sabbath, his outburst in the temple. Nicodemus, you are a righteous man. Do not be swayed by this Jesus. He's not the Messiah. He's not the prophet. And he's not the Son of God.
Caiaphas, we bring you Jesus of Nazareth. He took his time first, as you said, and he's declared him guilty. But he must be tried under your authority.
We're gathered to hear the evidence of this man. Guilty as charged and worthy of death. We must be careful as to how this man is tried. There could be a riot.
Are there witnesses? Bring the witnesses forward!
This man said he's able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days.
No, that's not what he said. He said, I'll destroy the temple, made with hands, and within 3 days, build another, made with our hands!
No, Caiaphas, he didn't say any of that. But I do remember seeing him healing on the Sabbath in the temple!
Silence! Do you answer nothing to what these men testify? What is it you teach the people?
I spoke openly to the world. I taught in the temple and in the synagogues and wherever the Jews gathered together. And in secret I said nothing. Why do you ask me? Ask those who heard me. They know what I taught.
You do not speak to the high priest like that.
If I spoke evil, bear witness of that evil. But if well, why do you strike me?
Caiaphas, he is right. And besides, we do not have enough evidence. This man...
Nicodemus! Have you been swayed also? Are you a follower of this man?
You mind yourself, Nicodemus. Are you the Christ? Are you the Son of the Most High God?
I am, and you shall see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of power of God.
Blasphemy! You heard him! His own words have condemned him! We don't need no witnesses!
Caiaphas, this man's crime is worthy of death! We have no law that can put this man to death!
Then take him to Pilate!
Life for my sake will find it.
Peter, you're a fisherman. How can you take on the Senate? Caiaphas will crush you. Simon Peter, you are just a simple, uneducated fisherman. What good will you, dying also, do anyone? You must deny him. You have no choice.
Peter, the rooster shall not crow this day before you will deny three times that you know me.
Lord, I will never deny you! Never, 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 never,
Crucify him! Over man.
my sweetest sweet dream. If they didn't hear you, there is no hope for salvation.
Thank you. Amen. Praise God. Those words, eternal words, it is finished, echo through the corridors of time and bring us to that point where Jesus accomplished what he intended to do. And the resurrection brought us a new dimension, a new life. So praise God. We thank God for the cast. You think it was amazing?
Yeah.
We've labored tirelessly behind the scenes. There's so many people involved and they've all labored tirelessly. I've seen the pastor overseeing the project. Praise God. And I want to thank you for coming. It's been a real blessing this weekend. You know, so many times we do forget what this weekend is about, but it's a good reminder for us. Now, our Archbishop's going to come and share a few words with us in a moment. But I just want to just tell you a bit about us as well. You know, we've been in the community for a very long time, you know, since in this area, since 1997 in this area. But before that, we do a lot of work in the community with the hospitals and homeless projects and football projects and sports projects. So we're there to reach out to the community because Jesus has touched our lives. So we want to proclaim that out there. So what we're going to do, we're going to take up an offering just to help us along with this work. And we're going to pass a basket. If you can, please make a donation. If you can't, don't worry, let the basket pass you by. But it's all for the work that we do. And we believe in love in action. So God bless you.
To Christ.
Amen. Amen. Carry on if you will. Amen. I'm going to ask Archbishop Edmund to come and pray for the offering. So I want to acknowledge Archbishop Frimpong is in the house as well. Praise God. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. I wouldn't have given up this for anything. I was in Estonia. I have to come last night, so I will be part of this today. I'm so touched, I'm so moved, and I could see some people wiping the tears of their eye. And this thing happened 2,000 years ago. And if today it can still have impact on you, it tells you that there is God. Amen. You and I are here not because of what we have done or can do, but it's all because of what He did. If you have never read the Bible, you have seen the enacts of what took place 2,000 years ago. Without the cross, there wouldn't have been the victory. Take up your cross, and you have your victory. God bless you all. Father, we thank you and we bless you for this opportunity. We thank you for the fellowship. We thank you for what has taken place today. Even if we cannot read the Holy Bible, we have seen with our very eyes what you did, the price you paid to set us free. We thank you, Lord Jesus. If you are there, Jesus, we thank you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We ask that today will be a day of a new beginnings in the life of each and every one of you. We have given our offerings today, but I remember what Jesus said to Caiaphas. He says, you cannot have power until it has been given unto you. There's no way we could have had this offering, but because it was given to us first from God. Amen. We bless this offering. We bless this ministry. We bless everyone here today in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ who has risen today. I say, Shalom.
Amen. 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 Just going to invite our Archbishop now to come and share a few words with us. If we give the Lord a clap offering for his life.
Thank you. God bless you. Turn to your neighbor, welcome each other. Just turn to your neighbor, extend the hand of welcome. Amen. Just like to invite Archbishop, come to the front as well with us. Is Archbishop here? Frimpong, come join us here, please. God bless you. It's good to be here. Let's give a clap on. Thank you, Archbishop Edmund, Archbishop Frimpong, Reverend Christie, First Lady, and any visitors, you're welcome to ACC. It's good to have you. Let me just say, as Morris said, a few words, just to say a few words. But again, always powerful, always moving what God is doing through each one of their lives. And each person has their own personal testimony. Amen. Come from different backgrounds, but we've been united in Christ. Our center is Jesus Christ's faith in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We see there's conflict all over the world. If you saw the news rules early this morning, what's happening overseas with the bombings and all these things taking place, it's the unregenerated nature. And the purpose that Jesus came was to change the condition of our outlook, give us a new sight, a new hearing, new way of thinking, new way of speaking, transforming the human condition. Because at the beginning, if you take the narrative of the creation story of Adam and Eve, that represents how we came about. Because I know evolution cannot answer questions. You know, it says the theory of evolution, you have to have more faith, in fact, to believe evolution. If you look at the process, how things came about, from a little piece of matter, you know, to come into creation. You need more faith to believe that than to believe in a true living God. We have to have come from somewhere. And in fact, the gospel story of the message of the gospel story is lost by the trappings of the Western world, the 21st century and commercialism. The meaning's really being lost. It's all about bunny rabbits and eggs and all the rest of it. Even though there's something nice about that, it's more than that. And basically, if you know the Jewish story of the children of Israel being caught in captivity in Egypt for so many years, and they were looking for a redeemer, a savior, and he came in the person of Moses, who led the children of Israel out of Egypt. And in fact, every truth has a parallel. Truth is parallel. And in fact, the gospel story is the fulfillment of what happened in Egypt. I just want to say just a few words about it, because the Easter message is really lost by, it's lost in translation. This is in fact what Moses did with the children of Israel, is what Jesus did to the world. Because Egypt represented symbolically and allegorically the kingdom of Satan, the kingdom of darkness. And Moses was the light, the one who drew people out of the bondage of satanic powers, and the taskmasters represented demonic powers. And when Christ came into the world, he was acting as the fulfillment of a Moses and an Aaron, because Aaron was the first high priest. Our Lord and Savior is the true high priest without beginning of days and without ending of days. I hope I'm speaking to someone, because, you know, we lose the meaning, all the confusion that happened in the world. And what happened is that when the children of Israel left Egypt, after the Lord struck them with the 10 plagues, he instructed them to kill a lamb. And that's why in the narrative where we saw when Abraham had Isaac, his son. In fact, Isaac's son, when God asked him to sacrifice him, was about 30, 33 years old. And the place where God led Abraham to sacrifice his son was a place called Mount Moriah. And in fact, Mount Moriah is Jerusalem, the same place that Jesus Christ was crucified. I mean, you can't work it out. Even if you try to work it out, you cannot bring it fulfilled. That prophetic word and declaration, no one human can do it. It had to be God intervention to make it come to fulfillment. And so when Isaac asked his father, where is the lamb? Where is the sacrificial lamb? He said, the Lord himself will provide. If you read Genesis chapter 22, you read the narrative there. And it wasn't until that John the Baptist, who identified, answered Isaac's question. It was John the Baptist who said, behold the Lamb of God, and it was Jesus Christ. So in the same way the lamb had to be sacrificed when they were leaving Egypt, and the blood had to be put on the doorpost, on the lintels and the doorpost, the blood of Christ safeguards us, protects us. And when the blood was shed, we were empowered, because it was innocent blood. And I don't want to go through a whole theological exposition of what that means and represents. You need to come to ACC to hear more in future weeks when we preach the word and teach the word. But I'm saying to you, something profound took place that has changed history as was known then. We were in darkness, we came to light. We were hopeless, he gives us hope. We were in trouble, he gave us a way out. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And he gives us back, he restores us into the place that we had fallen from, and that is in relationship with his Father in heaven. So as you leave this place, think about what this season really speaks about. What is it all about? It's not just about ritual, it's not about religion, it's about faith, it's about relationship, not just with each other, but with God. Because your relationship with God will determine your relationship with each other, because it's vertical and horizontal. If you have a true understanding of God, as Jesus says, the first commandment is to love God with all your heart, all your mind, all your strength, and your soul. The second commandment is like it, is to love your neighbor as yourself. It is impossible to love your neighbor as yourself unless you have a relationship with God. Look at the world, it's so much torn apart, ripped apart. Everyone hates each other. Everyone is fighting with each other. It's only with God intervention that we can have true, not conditional love, but unconditional, irrespective of culture, background, status in life, that we can love each other as he has loved us. So with those few words, I don't want to go talk at you. Just think about it. When you leave here, think what the message represented. But the greater, the victor, in the end, is always God. He's the victor. And we saw that display when Deacon Andrew and Donna, our music director, had that conflict, fought with each other. Ultimately, God will always win. It may not look like it, but God will always come through. The Bible declares that, shows it, reveals it. And we embrace it and accept it, and our lives can be transformed. So we love you. God bless you. Have a wonderful day today. And in fact, we have two Easters, actually. Next week is the Easter and Easter. Irrespective of the two periods of Easter, God is one. He's the same. Praise the Lord for all of us, to cover us all through his love. So God bless you. Let's stand together. There's a song I'd like us to sing in closing. You know the song? There's a song, we're going to close with this song. And listen to the words. If you come forward, all the cost, let Jesus come through the crowds. Thank Manuel. This is the 10th year. Praise. Let's give the Lord a clap offering. Thank the senior pastor for the vision. It's the 10th year we have been presenting. And I'm reluctant to say performing. because this is not a performance. This is presenting our faith. It's different. You know, they're not Hollywood actors, but they're better than Hollywood actors because they're inspired by the Holy Spirit. So it's moving what God has done through the years. I know people still speak about their experience with this enactment, what took place here, when I meet people outside, how it touched them. And it actually changed their attitude, changed their outlook, because it really resonated with their spirit, because we need love. Billy Graham once said, if you show love to people, it will cure many ill ailments. And neuroscientists say this, that 98% of ailments are due to thought processes, not DNA, okay, and environment, but they're due to mind thoughts. When you have negative thoughts, it impacts your being and brings sicknesses, brings ailments. And there's a lot of statistics down to show that people pray, their immune system is better than people don't pray. This is statistic. This is actually being researched. So if you want your immune system, you want to be well, you want the best medicine, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen. So just let's go to...
For all the earth had trembled, the sun had hidden his face, and all the men that walked with him had turned and run away. They crucified our Savior and laid him in a tomb. The life that once brought love and hope slipped away that afternoon. Satan gleamed with pleasure that day at Calvary, for he thought he had won a mighty victory. And like him, all of the demons of hell began to cheer. Oh, but little did they know that the end was drawing
He's alive. And because he lives, we can face tomorrow. Amen. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear has gone. Because I know he will. It's worth a living just because he lives. I want you to lift up your hand because Jesus lives. You can live tomorrow. Lift up your hands and thank God for the resurrection power. He's risen. The grave could never contain him. Now we thank God for the acts and everything that has been a practical time. Let's come and watch this scene that happened 2,000 years ago. And today, I want you to be happy because the blood has been shed for you. Without the shedding of the blood, there was no remission of sin. And today, don't leave this place with your guilty life because a price has been paid on your behalf. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 20 says, we were bought with a price. Not the price of goats and cows and everything. That the Old Testament, it was an atonement. But the New Testament is the blood of Jesus. That paid for you. Lift up your hands. Father in heaven, thank you for today. The first day of the month of April. For this wonderful celebration. Lord, the whole world is rejoicing because Christ is risen. We thank you for the show. We thank you for the preparation. We thank you for his amen, the Archbishop, for all what he's doing in the community. We thank you for the church. We thank you for the senior pastor who put out the program, who oversee the program. We thank you for everybody who has been part of today's service. We thank you for the world globally watching us. And we thank God that the resurrection power has come to us. Father, we thank God for Jesus, for the gift of love. That he came. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Father, bless each and everyone. And let your name be glorified. As we walk through the streets, we come against the spirit of darkness. We walk through the streets in Enfield, in Harrogate, and all parts of London. We pray for the knife and gun crime to come to an end. We deliver this nation from the evils of the world. Father, let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name, and let the church say, amen. Amen.
God bless you all. Please take the person's hand on your right or your left as we say the benediction. The grace of our Lord, the Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of us now and forevermore. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. God bless you. Praise God. God bless.